लीड कोट बाई वीकली कॉन्टेस्ट 94. ओके लेट्स सी, आई हैवंट सॉल्वड एनी लीड कोट कॉन्टेस्ट इन लाइक मंथ्स. आई होप दे गिव अस एन आईडी. I wonder what network request they make. Okay, we have our first question. Can't handle this request, why? Okay, my internet is working for sure. You're given a zero index integer array for its length n, representing the position of several floats. Move your army from one of your forts at position I to an empty position J such that the army will enemy forts only, travels over enemy forts only. While moving the army, all the enemy forts that come in the way are captured. Return the maximum number of enemy forts that can be captured. In case it is impossible to move your army or you do not have any fort under your command, return 0. Okay. Okay. Auto. I don't really know how to use auto. Okay, we go through the vector size. Can I change its name? F dot length or size? I don't even know that. So let's first keep a count of one. If f of I is equals 1, count 1 plus. If count 1 is equals 0, return 0. The enemy fort is 0, minus 1. So you have to move from 1 to minus 1. So that is 2 forts captured. And then 4 forts. I think we can capture all forts, right? Zero to position 3 captures 2 enemy forts, 1 and 2. 8 to 3, wait a second. 8 to 3, okay, my bad. So we have multiple captured forts. I've never seen that the first question to be this difficult. I mean, this could be easy. I must be thinking something wrong. Fort length is 1000, so we can probably do it in O of N square. So if I get every position of captured forts and I get every position of empty. Oh, we cannot jump over empty, right? So we cannot jump over empty. So we can basically go to the next or the previous empty foot. So that means the maximum number of foots we can, and how many times can we do it? See, if I move from here to here, two forts will be captured. And if this was a minus one, can I move it again? Can I make just one change, or I can make multiple? Okay, I think I made only one change, so we can only jump once. So which means we can keep track of position of empty left, I guess. Suppose it was negative one, let's keep it negative one. And if let's keep an answer, int answer is equals to zero. And else if f of I is equals to negative one, I'm gonna set pos empty left to be equal to I, and f pos empty left was not equal to negative one, then max of answer comma I minus pos empty left plus one. So if I have minus one here and then one here, sorry, minus one here and one here, then 1 minus 0 plus 1, that would be 2. That is wrong. It should be minus 1. So these many enemy will be captured for the left side. And if I find an empty thing, and I have found a captured is equals to one. So just like this. Compilation error. What do you mean by that? Answer is 4 is correct, but for the second test case, that is this thing, this should be 0. Just gonna submit this. Wrong answer again. So I have expected is 2, but five. That's weird. Why would it print 5? Let me copy this. How much fun it is to ride on one horse open sleigh. Hey, jingle bells, jingle bells, jingle all the way. How much fun it is to ride on one horse open sleigh. Hey, jingle bells, jingle all the way. How much fun it is to ride on one horse open sleigh. Hey, jingle bells, jingle bells, jingle all the way. Fun it is to ride on one horse open sleigh. Okay. So this is the problem, I guess. So this position capture might be after an empty space. So at this point, I'm just gonna do position empty left to be equal to -1, because that's what we do. And I'm gonna do pause. Captured some of this accepted finally. Let's see the leaderboard. There is no ranking. What the or hmm, 6628 with a bug. You're given two strings arrays, positive feedback and negative feedback, containing the words denoting positive and negative feedback. Note that no word is both positive and negative. Initially, every student had 0 points. Each positive word in a feedback report increased the points by of a student by 3, whereas each negative word decreased the points by 1. You are given n feedback reports represented by a 0 index string array report and a 0 index integer array student ID. ID of the student who has received the feedback report I. The ID of each student is unique. Given integer k, return the top k students after ranking them in non-increasing order by their points. In case more than one student has the same points, the one with the lower ID ranks higher. So, so the length of the string arrays is between 10 to the power 4 to 1. What is this? So each string is up to 100 characters long. No word is present in both. n is equal to put this, n is 10 to the power 4. Okay, so 10 to the power 4 into 100 should be doable, right? In 1 second. And I don't even know what the time limit is. I'm just gonna do it like this. So I'm just gonna create a map, unordered map. So map string to an integer points for problem is that I don't know. Okay, never mind. Positive feedback, let's make it PF and make this NF. So just gonna change this to M, just gonna change to N, just gonna go till M. I'm just gonna change to N. I'm just gonna change to 1 1, and then I'm just gonna traverse the sequence to what report, right? Size. Oh wait, R is a string. Why not just give it in vector, right? I don't even know if we do this or just do R dot length. Let's just run this and we'll know if we have compilation errors. For if, so I'm gonna declare a string void, and if R of I is equals empty, then I'm gonna check. First I'm gonna if not, then I'm gonna add it to the void, and if this happens, I'm just gonna make void to be equal to an empty string again, and I'm gonna check if this void exist in a points. See, we have to print the largest K students, right? K students, okay. I'm just gonna create an answer vector. Vector int? Okay, int, let's say. So, plus equals to this. And gonna push back a pair of int. this is going to have the answer comma index, and for index I'm just gonna weird. Wait a second, I have misunderstood something. Report is in, report is a vector of string, right? It's not a string. The fuck was I doing? Oh shit. This was correct. Can't move it up. This editor is the worst. I should use my own editor. At least I can copy paste. So the index would be I, right? Should be I. And I'm gonna sort answer one dot sort, and this is Python syntax answer one dot end. I'm gonna return, so I have an answer to for int I equals 0, I less than k, I plus plus. So I'm gonna reverse this as well. So I'm just gonna copy this string, paste it here, reverse. Thank god that works. And I'm gonna answer to dot pushback. What am I gonna push back? Answer one of I dot second. Return answer two. And I hope that this works. If R I okay. Hmm. 1,0, is it correct? The output is 1,2. Everything is 0 indexed. Oh, the student IDs are this. Okay. You don't have to panic, guys. You don't have to panic. So this is going to be, instead of I, I'm just going to use R of I, SID of I, right? Two comma one is wrong. Why is this wrong? Custom test cases. I don't even know what this doing. Weird stuff. Let me print the answers, right? Zero. That's kind of harsh. Why is that happening? Let's print the word. This student is Why are they not printing other words? Okay, my bad. Student is not studious, and why is that shit not coming? Weird, right? It's not working, it's not working. Okay, at the end I have to also do that. Student is studious, the student is smart, the student is not studious. Okay, so they got 3 points because studious was in it, right? This guy got 6 points. How the fuck did he get 6 points? That's weird. I have one positive feedback, 3 points, but okay, I have not made answer to be zero again. My bad. So this should be like this. Three, three, two, three. Okay. Still wrong, guys. This should be Why is the sorting not happening correctly? Okay. So what this will do is, that's why you should know how to make a custom compare function. Or I can just do this greater now. If p1 dot first is equals p2 dot first, we return true in JavaScript when we want to swap, but in C++ we do it for something else. We do it the opposite way, I guess. So in this condition, I would not like to swap, right? This condition I won't want to swap, because the one with the lower index is coming first. I'm gonna return false. I don't know, swap, and else I'm just gonna return. So if p1 greater than p2 dot first, agar bada hai to use pehle dalenge, right? So that means I don't want to swap, so I'm gonna swap here. I don't know. I don't know how this works. Just what do you want me to do? This is exactly what I did. Doesn't work. Weird stuff. this.com. This is bullshit. I'm just gonna. What the fuck did that just happen? Just soldered, I don't even know how I did. I just put here a static and then that non-static number should be called resolved itself. I don't know what the fuck. Let's see my ranking now. 2443. Not bad, not bad. We have two arrays, array 1 and array 2, which are initially empty. You need to add positive integers to them such that they satisfy all the following conditions. Array 1 contains unique count 1 distinct positive integers, each of which is not divisible by divisor 1. No integer is present in both. Given divisor 1 and 2 and unique counts, return the minimum possible maximum integer that can be present in either array. Minimum possible maximum integer? What do they mean by this? Minimum possible maximum integer. Okay, let's see some test cases. So divisor 1 is 2, divisor 2 is 7. Output is 4. We can distribute the first 4 natural numbers. Into array 1 and array 2. Array 1 can be 1 and array 2 can be 2, 3 and 4. We can see that both arrays satisfy all the conditions. Okay, so the conditions are ek hona chahiye iske andar aur isme 3 hona chahiye alag alag. And any one of this should not be divisible by 2 and any one of this is not divisible by 7, which is true. So the maximum value is 4, we'll return it. What? Minimum possible maximum integer. Oh, now I get it. The maximum of all these and we have to minimize it. So we will start from 1, 2 and 3 and 4. So basically, let's see this thing. Array 1 and 2 and array 2, 3. Satisfies all conditions and the maximum value is 3, we return it. Okay. So we create two vectors. That's gonna be, the vectors are gonna be array 1 and array 2. go to, okay, unique count can be up to 10^9, so we cannot make a for loop up to 10^9, so that's a bad idea, so we have to solve it without it. So if it were not 10^9, we would actually just do like go from 1 to, I don't know, this 10^5. Oh, the divisor is this. So I'm just gonna go up till n or infinity until I fill. But since the unique count is up till 10^9, so what if both are 10^9? Then I cannot find any numbers. Okay. So is it possible that one number, like let's say x, is not in both? Of course it is possible, right? It can be true that that number is like 15, so it cannot be inside of both of these arrays. So it's kind of like a Fizbuzz question, right? No, this is present both. Okay. So the number of such x's that will not be present in both would be so the number of x that is not present in both would be unique maximum of unique count of 1 and 2. Wait a second. Number can be anything, right? So int so there are divisor 1 minus 1 numbers between 1 to div 1, right or wrong? So like if this is 3, then 3 minus 1, 2 numbers are there. So if we go like this, then to achieve unique count numbers where so to reach unique count numbers in UC1 and UC2. We would just divide UC1. No, not divide. Or maybe divide this by div 1 minus 1. So this is gonna give us the excess. But sum will, okay, so these many numbers Let me just check if this is actually true. So if I want to do like 6, not 3, 6 and then 9, let's say. So the numbers are 1 and 2, which is correct. And 4 and 5, so which is incorrect, right? So there are only 4 numbers. Instead, there should have been 9. Take that, take it. It's fine. It's fine. And so these will be the numbers. Be the numbers not divisible by 1, sorry, div 1. So sum will go in div 2 and sum can go in div 1. Sorry, array 1. And this doesn't even make sense. Something is wrong. This thing is preventing me from using this as my for int loop. Plus, the constraints are pretty high. You know what? I can't even imagine what to do. Okay, so unique count 1 plus unique count 2 is also less than equal to 10 per 9. But what is that good for? Okay, let's, how many numbers would be? How many numbers, let's keep this as 10 per 9. So how many numbers would not come in both that are between 1 to 1 9? So that would be 1, that would be the count of that would be long long count not in boats would be equal to 1e9, that is mx, divided by, and this is going to be an integer division, so mx divided by what, div divisor 1 into divisor 2, why, no, right, no, it's not gonna be that, because 2 into 2 into 5 would also not be in both if d1 is equals to 2 and d2 is equals to 5, then that a number that is like this would also not be. Okay, let's just keep this to be not in D1. Let's keep it D1 and D2. And similarly, I'm just gonna copy this line. Say count number of not in D2. And now there's gonna be some overlap. How am I gonna figure that overlap? That is going to be, so the overlap would be equal to mx d1 into d2. So this is the final, this would be equal to this thing plus this thing minus overlap. So these many numbers are not gonna be in both. But why were we doing this? We were doing this because the answer is nothing but I just assumed that maximum is gonna be 1e9. We just have to find the maximum number. So if both could if all numbers from 1 to n could go in both arrays, then the answer would be equal to UC1 plus UC2, right? But since, let's say, one number cannot go both, the answer automatically increases by one, right? So the minimum answer we have is UC1 plus UC2, ये तो है ही, ठीक है? प्लस इसके अंदर जितने नहीं थे वो ऐड करने पड़ेंगे, अब इसको कॉपी करते हैं, इसको पेस्ट करते हैं, अज्यूम करते हैं कि ये समय है, अब इसमें ये वाले थे जो दोनों में नहीं आए, ठीक है, तो ये अगर मैं ऐड कर दूँ तो यही आंसर नहीं हो जाएगा, नॉट हैप्पी विद दिस, बट लेट्स सी, सिक्स इज नॉट द आंसर, आउटपुट इज 4. बैम, सिक्स फोर सिक्सटीन, मुझे रॉन्ग, कंप्लीटली रॉन्ग, इसमें हमें मिनिमम एक चाहिए, इसमें हमें तीन चाहिए, तो मिनिमम आंसर तो हो गया 4, ठीक है, जो कि सही है, तो मिनिमम आंसर हमारा 4 हो गया. अब 4 में हम ऐड करेंगे जो 4 तक 2 और 7 से डिवाइड नहीं हुए, तो ऐसा कोई भी नंबर नहीं था, तो यहाँ पे क्या आएगा, यहाँ पे आएगा 4 डिवाइडेड बाय 2, तो दैट मीन्स इसके अंदर ऐसे दो नंबर्स आए जो 2 से डिविजिबल थे, ठीक है, और दूसरा क्या होगा, 4 डिवाइडेड बाय 7, तो ये आया आपके पास 0, ठीक है. अब जो दोनों में आए वो होंगे 14 से वाले, ठीक है, ओके, तो मेरा गलत है ये तरीका, जो बोथ्स में आए वो भी 0 होंगे, राइट, 0, दैट मीन्स ओके, माय नॉट इन बोथ्स के बजाय मेरे को लग रहा है मिनिमम आंसर प्लस इक्वल्स टू ओवरलैप, आई गेस 4, 3 and 11, 4, 3 and 11, so ये वाला ले लेते हैं टेस्ट केस, आई गेस तो ये तो गलत ही है क्योंकि 4, 4, 4, 2 वाले भी नहीं आएंगे, राइट.
कैसे निकालो नंबर्स जिसमें
डी वन की पावर एक्स है, ठीक है, डी वन की पावर ए है एंड डी टू की पावर बी है, और ए एंड बी बोथ आर ग्रेटर देन इक्वल टू वन। ठीक है, और ये मल्टीप्लिकेशन में ऑफ कोर्स ऐसे नंबर्स कैसे निकालो इनका काउंट। बिटवीन यू वन एंड यू टू, और उसके बाद भी आंसर सही नहीं आएगा क्योंकि क्योंकि जब हम ऊपर जाएंगे उतने नंबर्स हमें और लेने पड़ेंगे, राइट। लेकिन उसमें भी तो हो सकता है कोई डी वन और डी टू का मल्टीपल हो, तो ये तो मुझे समझ नहीं आ रहा।
वी टुक वन टू एन नंबर्स एंड देन या तो वन में डालो आर ए में या टू से में डालो।
इंस्टेड हमें ये करना चाहिए कि वन को पहले पहले पूरा फिल कर दो, फिर नहीं दिस इज डिफिकल्ट, लेट्स नॉट वर। ओके, सो यू गिवन स्ट्रिंग ए इज कंटेनिंग वन ऑफ मोर वर्ड्स, एवरी कंसेक्यूटिव पेयर ऑफ वर्ड्स इज सेपरेटेड बाय सिंगल स्पेस, अ स्ट्रिंग टी इज एन एनाग्राम ऑफ अ स्ट्रिंग एस इफ द आईथ वर्ड ऑफ टी इज अ परम्यूटेशन ऑफ द आईथ वर्ड ऑफ एस। एनाग्राम ऑफ एस इफ द आईथ वर्ड, फॉर एग्जाम्पल ए सी बी डी एफ ई इज एन एनाग्राम ऑफ ए बी सी डी ई एफ, बट डी ई एफ कैप इज नॉट। इफ द आईथ वर्ड ऑफ टी इज अ परम्यूटेशन ऑफ द आईथ, ओके गॉट इट गॉट इट। इट इज द नंबर ऑफ डिस्टिंक्ट एनाग्राम्स ऑफ एस, distinct anagrams, since the answer may be very large return it module is, oh I think this is, I thought this was okay, so let's keep the answer to be one. So for I'm just gonna have a set. So I'm gonna say that this is gonna be n dot length, and then I'm gonna go while s of I is not equals to I wonder what is the complexity of plus equals to, because I just use it all the time and I should not use it, I think. Why do you use a set when you can use a character of an int array? Vector int ch26,0, and I'm just gonna do ch of minus a. Doesn't contains lower Latin letters or anything. So I'm just gonna count. I'm just gonna multiply by the factorial, right? So int mod equals to 1 in 9 plus 7. So int factorial. How am I gonna find the factorial? I should actually do it in Python. No, just kidding. इसमें कहाँ यूज़ हो रही है डीपी यूज़ करो यार. Yes, it would be a good idea. There should be functions. It was not that difficult, but I'm just gonna use this. So numbers are gonna be. Is dot length is up to as per 5. So I guess storing up to 25, this should be fine. Wait a minute. I did have to rewrite all of this function. I'm just printing Fibonacci. I'm just doing the worst thing that is ever possible. Ah no, I'm so bad. Or we could have done a pre-computation of all the factorials from. Oh no, I'm so bad. I don't know, this actually doesn't fucks up. This might actually fuck up. I don't even know. I am looking forward to printing some of the factorials myself now. Such a bad day, such a bad day. I don't know if that's required. So this is going to be divide factor. Well, that is concerning me now. Int. Why should that be true? And get it. It's just what you want me to do, really? Shit, man. Out of line, what the fuck do you mean? I've never faced such a situation before. That is funny. Let me just remove this then. Declarator. The fuck do you mean, bro? That's weird. Okay, let's see this later, maybe. 6 minutes left. Okay. I couldn't do anything. GG's, though.